Hi guys, this is new video tutorial on PHP web development, and here we have learned how can we generate unique slug or URL of particular title. Unique slug is most important part of our website because based on that slug it will load content related to particular page. So if there is same URL in our database, then it will load data of two pages on web page, and which is biggest mistake in programming. So generating of unique slug is required if we have working on any content or e-commerce site using PHP script. So here we make this simple tutorial in which we will learn how to create unique slug in PHP. Now let's start discussing this topic. So this is our testing database, and in this we have one slug table with three column like slug ID, slug title, and slug URL. We will generate slug of any title and store into this table, then after we will enter same title and check our PHP script generate unique slug or not. This is our index page. First on this page we have create one form, so here we have write form tag with attribute method is equal to post. Under this form we have write input type is equal to text, name is equal to title. Under this text box we can enter title for generate unique slug. For submit form data we have write input type is equal to submit, name is equal to create, and value is equal to create. By click on this button we can submit form data for generate unique slug. Now we have moved to write PHP script for create unique slug. So first we want to make database connection. So we have write $connect variable is equal to new class with 3 argument. In first argument we have write mysql host is equal to localhost, database name is equal to testing, username set to root and password set to blank. After making database connection we have write $slug variable is equal to blank value. Under this variable we will store unique slug which will be generating. Below this we have write if statement, and under condition we have write ESET function with $post create variable. If this variable value is set then it will execute if block of code. Under this block we have write $slug variable is equal to preg replace function with 3 argument. In first pattern argument we have write this pattern which accept only alphabet and number. In second replacement argument we have write dash, and in third string argument we have write trim function, and under this function we have write string to lower function, and under this we have write $post title variable. This code will check if there is any character other than alphabet and number, then it will replace that character with dash, and by using string to lower function text data will be converted into lowercase, and by using trim function it will remove width e-space from string. After generate slug from title now we have write $query variable is equal to select slug URL column from slug table where slug URL like $slug variable with percentage wildcard character. This query will search those data in which slug URL column string start with value of $slug variable. For example $slug variable value is PHP, then it will return data like PHP tutorial, PHP video tutorial. Below this we have write $statement variable is equal to $connect variable with prepare statement with $query variable, it will make query for execution. Now we have write if statement and under condition we have write $statement variable with execute method. If query successfully run then it will execute if block of code. Under this block we have write $total row variable is equal to $statement variable with row count method. This method will return number of row affected by query execution. After this we have write if statement and under condition we have write $total row variable value greater than 0 then it will execute if block of code. Under this block we have write $result variable is equal to $statement variable with fetch all method. This method will return query execution result and store under $result variable. After this we have write for each loop and under condition we have write $result variable as $row variable. By using this loop we can fetch data from $result variable. Under this loop we have write $data variable is equal to $row slug URL variable. So here we have store this column data under this $data variable. Now we have write if statement and under condition we have write in array function with two argument like $slug variable and $data variable. This condition will check if $slug variable value in which we have store slug which we have generated and in $data variable we have store slug data which we have fetch from slug table. So if $slug variable value found under this $data variable then it will execute if block of code and under this block we have write $count variable value is equal to 0. Below this we have write while loop and under condition we have write in array function with two argument like $slug variable append-append $count variable increase by 1 and second argument we have write $data variable. If $slug variable value found under $data variable then by using while loop in which we have generate slug and it will keep incrementing $count variable value until a space found. Now we want to update $slug variable value by appending $count variable value and it will generate unique slug from title. Lastly we want to insert slug data into slug table so we have write $insert data variable is equal to array with double colon slug title key with value $post title variable and double colon slug URL key with value get from $slug variable value. So here we have store data in $insert data variable. Below this we have write $query variable is equal to insert into slug table with table column like slug title, slug URL with values get from double colon slug title and slug URL. After this we have write $statement variable is equal to $connect variable with prepare statement with $query variable. It will make query for execution. Lastly we want to execute query, so we have write $statement variable with execute method and under this we have write $insert data variable, it will execute query and insert data into slug table. Now we want to display unique slug on web page so here we have write echo statement with $slug variable, it will display unique slug on web page. Now we have check output in browser. Friends, here we can see when page has been load into browser, then we can see simple form for enter title text box with create button. Now in text box we have write PHP tutorial in text box field and click on create button, and after click on button on web page we can see PHP tutorial slug on web page. After this again we have write PHP tutorial in text box field and click on create button, and after click on button we can see PHP tutorial 1 slug on web page. So here it has generate unique slug. We have enter same title for 2 time again, and after submit of form it has generate unique slug. In slug table we can see unique generate slug URL in slug table. Now we have removed this URL like PHP tutorial 3, and now we want to check which slug has been generated from this PHP tutorial title. So here we have write PHP tutorial and click on create button, then it has generate PHP tutorial 5 in slug. So it has generate unique slug. So if you are looking for unique slug generation tutorial, then it will helpful to you. If you have any query regarding this PHP video tutorial part, please comment your query in comment box, or if you like this video tutorial please share with your friends, or even you can also share on social media also. If you want to get more update regarding our PHP video tutorial, please subscribe our YouTube channel for get more update regarding release of future video. Lastly, keep watching our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching this video tutorial.